Hi everyone, I'm Cody Holyoke in Overland Park at the Museum at Prairie Fire, where we have a special treat for you today. It's a new exhibit dedicated to the Permian Monster. And you might ask, what's a Permian Monster? I'm going to ask that of you, Terry Thompson. Thanks for showing us around. So these predate dinosaurs.
They absolutely do predate dinosaurs. For the first 100 years of paleontology, they actually kind of overlooked these smaller, strange fossils because they were going for the big, bad dinosaur bones. But then when they kind of circled back around and started to check them out a little bit more, they realized that they predated dinosaurs by a whole period. They actually existed in the Permian period. So this right here is kind of a cool example. It's a griffin fly.
Okay.
Its wingspan is up to 2.5 feet long, and it has really powerful jaws. And it was the predominant aerial predator long before pterosaurs.
It's a nasty dragonfly.
I would not want that in my backyard.
How do they, so because obviously this is a recreation, how do they go through and form some of the exhibits that we're about to see?
So they start with the fossils,
okay.
And then there's a lot of scientific knowledge and information that's applied to the fossils and how those fossils orient with how the bones orient with each other, and they'll look at another creature and what they know of that creature, and they'll apply it to this particular one, and it's a lot more knowledge than I have.
That's all right, but it is really cool, though.
Yeah.
I mean, you show us this little creature over here.
It looks cute, but it also looks like it would be a very little vicious creature.
Yeah.
Do you see the teeth?
Oh,
do you see the just tons of tiny little sharp teeth in this guy.
Lose a finger. Wow.
I mean, and quick, fast-moving creature. And I believe this one, he's an amphibian.
Oh, okay.
So, you don't want to be caught on the beach with him.
That's right. And so they take, and this would be the skeleton?
This is the fossil.
The fossil.
Yes. And then they just have to figure it out, applying their scientific knowledge. It's incredible. It's amazing what they do.
And there's a link you were saying on TV about humanity a little bit. They have some features they share, features with humans.
Yes, actually. That was kind of the really cool part when they circled back around and started to study these fossils, is that they actually found that they're more closely related to humans than they are to dinosaurs.
That's true.
And they're actually now known as stem mammals, which is incredible and a little unnerving considering the Permian ice caps are starting to melt.
What sort of things are we going to find?
Exactly. So pretty interesting. Might be some pretty interesting creatures in there. We don't know. But so that's kind of what made scientists kind of like the scientific community sit up and take notice of, wow, these are actually stem mammals.
This is really an educational experience, but it's also fun for the whole family. Over to our left here, you have these dig pits, right? So a little bit of sand in here, and you can kind of get an idea of what paleontologists might have been doing, right?
Yes. And how actual ginger the work is.
Yeah.
You don't want to disturb the fossils too much. We've got some bigger guys over here.
I see that. They're moving.
They are. So this is one of my favorites. And the Edaphosaurus is really cool. I love the way he had what's apparently the original HVAC in that sail. He would use it to cool himself and heat himself from the sun, orienting his body accordingly. That's what scientists believe. And it looks pretty cool to me.
Mm-hmm.
But the Dimetrodon is my favorite. And I like this guy because it goes back to that whole stem mammal and how you can so clearly see the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, the digits. And if you look at it from just the right angle, it almost looks like a human in a push-up position.
With a big fin on his back.
It's a little scary. I'm just going to say.
And so is this the same animal as... This is our HVAC guy?
This is our Dimetrodon.
Oh, it is the same?
Yes,
it's the same one
as over here, yes. And see how you can clearly see the pelvis and the hip joints and a little scary, saying.
Really, really neat. And so we had dinosaurs after this then.
And what gave way for the dinosaurs to come was the extinction of these guys. So I was reading on a panel how they said, global warming. And I was like, global warming? Wait, I thought that was something that humans did. Actually, this global warming was caused by an earthquake eruption. That actually the lava flow from this earthquake went on for a million years and literally killed off over 90% of the species on the planet. It was the largest extinction event that we know of in Earth's history. Yeah.
Even bigger than with the dinosaurs.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, and it actually kind of gave way for dinosaurs to rise and become. So, yeah.
The fun part about this trip is that you said a lot of these bottles look a little familiar. So we're going to walk over here. I don't know if you guys are sci-fi fans. Maybe you like the Star Wars. But tell us about this.
Okay.
You do definitely see some similarities.
So I'm a huge sci-fi fan.
Yeah.
I'll never forget the day I sat in the theater and watched Star Wars for the very first time with my dad and my little brother. And the second I laid eyes on these guys, I was like, oh, there must be a connection. There has to be a connection. I feel it in my heart. But I looked at him, Rancor. I look over at that guy down over there, Jar Jar Binks.
Definitely got some of that.
Got some of that. And I can't figure out exactly who this guy makes me think of, but I'm thinking Imperial Soldier. I'm not quite sure. But I'm thinking that maybe the creators of Star Wars might have had some Permian monster influence.
A little inspired.
Who knows? But really cool. And I think that you should come on down and check it out for yourself. You know, anyone that wants to come down and see if that's what they see, I would love it.
7 days a week you guys are open. And if you come see this exhibit, you're actually helping a good cause.
You are. Actually, every time you come to the museum at Prairie Fire, you are helping our core mission program, which is KC Urban Advantage. KC Urban Advantage, we really provide a pathway out of poverty for Kansas City's most at-risk children, giving them access and opportunity to have a different life and to provide a different life for their next generation. It's a really incredible program. You can check it out at kcurbanadvantage.org.
All right. And so you can also, like you said, come learn yourself and also help other people learn, which is great. So come on down to the Museum of Prairie Fire in Overland Park and check out these cool exhibits and these cool monsters. In Overland Park, I'm Cody Holyoke, KVC 9 News.